Over the past few years, Yemen has become one of the largest and most capable missile powers in the Middle East, challenging the U.S. Navy fleets and hitting the Israeli regime from thousands of kilometers away with a high rate of success and accuracy. With an effective combination of domestic expertise and Iranian technological assistance, Yemen has assembled a tremendous ballistic and cruise missile arsenal for both naval and land operations. Not only that, they have advanced their missile program to such an incredible extent that they have been able to build a really challenging hypersonic missile arsenal, mainly with domestic resources and little Iranian assistance, showcasing their firm willingness to surpass the heaviest international sanctions. This large missile power has been the key for Yemen to tightly control the world's busiest and most important maritime trade routes in the Red Sea and the Indian Ocean. Today, we are going to take a detailed look into the terrifying missile power that transformed Yemen into a formidable power of the international waters. One of the fastest and most capable missiles in Yemen's arsenal is the Hatem II hypersonic missile. In December 2024, Yemen had claimed to have launched for the first time a hypersonic ballistic missile named Hatem II, capable of speeds exceeding Mach 8. The missile, developed domestically, incorporates modern technology and possesses advanced guidance capabilities and maneuverability, offering precise targeting capabilities over long distances. The Hatem II is a hypersonic missile powered by solid fuel and with smart control systems and maneuvering capabilities. This missile was successfully used to strike the MSC Sarah V, an Israeli-owned ship in the Arabian Sea. The targeted cargo ship was sailing approximately 450 kilometers from Nishtun in eastern Yemen. Analysts suggest that although the Yemeni armed forces claim the Hatem II missile was developed domestically, its design closely resembles the Kbar Shaykan missile from Iran. It is believed that Iran has likely provided experts and manufacturing facilities to Yemen to enable the production of the Kbar Shaykan missile. Experts assert that the Hatem II missile is actually a variant of the Kbar Shaykan II, the latest hypersonic version that poses significant challenges to modern air defense systems due to its speed surpassing Mach 8. The Kbar Shaykan is a more powerful variant of the Fateh 110 ballistic missile, featuring a longer range and solid propellant. The Kbar Shaykan ballistic missile can target up to 1,450 kilometers with hypersonic speeds. Another highly advanced long-range hypersonic ballistic missile that the Yemeni armed forces have indigenously developed is the Palestine II. The Palestine II is designed for long-range, high-speed precision strikes, capable of evading some of the world's most advanced missile defense systems, including Israel's Iron Dome and David's Sling. The most outstanding feature of this missile is that it achieves speeds of up to Mach 16, making it nearly impossible to intercept. With a range of 2,150 kilometers, it can strike deep into Israeli and Saudi territories. It carries a 500-kilogram high-explosive warhead capable of penetrating hardened structures, ensuring significant damage to critical infrastructure. The Palestine II has shifted regional dynamics, challenging traditional missile defense strategies and enabling Yemen to conduct asymmetric warfare effectively. Its ability to strike deep into enemy territory with precision and evade interception makes it a game-changing weapon in Yemen's arsenal, particularly in its support for Palestinian resistance and its ongoing conflict with Saudi Arabia and Israel. Next, Yemen has the Qaher family of reverse-engineered Russian-made V-755 surface-to-air missiles, modified for land attack missions. Yemen had previously acquired a significant number of SAM-2 air defense missiles, which were repurposed from surface-to-air missiles into Qaher-2 ballistic surface-to-surface missiles, and their more upgraded versions, the Qaher-2M missiles, successfully used against Saudi forces and their allies. The Yemeni armed forces revealed and first fired the Qaher-1 in December 2015. The missile can range 250 kilometers while carrying a 200-kilogram payload. The Qaher-M2 has a larger range of 400 kilometers with a 350-kilogram warhead. Yemen has also developed the anti-ship variant of the Qaher missile, equipped with substantial modifications along with an optical seeker similar to the Iranian Qadr missile, which was unveiled as the Mohit. Equipped with a range of around 400 kilometers, The Mujeed missile is the first long-range anti-ship ballistic missile in Yemen's naval arsenal. Iran has officially confirmed that this Yemeni missile is directly modeled after the Iranian Qadr missile. It is fitted with an electro-optic guidance sensor and advanced avionics and guidance system that includes a terminal seeker, providing it with a better ability to penetrate the hard and soft defense suits of most targeted ships. The missile has a range of up to 180 kilometers and carries a warhead weighing about 150 kilograms. Another Yemeni anti-ship missile of devastating firepower is the Asef, a maritime variation of the Iranian Fateh 313 surface-to-surface missile with a maximum range of about 450 kilometers and a special warhead developed by Iran, weighing about 550 kilograms. It is a non-separating single missile equipped with an imaging guidance, combining infrared or electro-optical sensors. Yemen has recently developed the Tankil missile, a self-propelled maritime variation of the Iranian Rod 500 short-range ballistic missile with a range of 500 kilometers and a warhead of over 300 kilograms. It is also from the same Iranian surface-to-surface missile family and apparently features the same warhead and a penetrating separating body. This high-speed anti-ship missile can reach a maximum speed of Mach 8 or 8 times the speed of sound. This fourth-generation ballistic missile also incorporates an improved aerodynamic design and terminal precision capability. Beyond Asef and Tankil, the Yemeni armed forces have three smaller anti-ship ballistic missiles, which strongly resemble Iranian design philosophy and seeker technology, but do not precisely match known Iranian systems. These are the Falik, Mayun, and Albar al-Amar. Albar al-Amar is notably the Arabic name for the Red Sea. It's also believed to be a maritime version of the Iranian guided missile Fajr 4CL, based on Iranian technology. The Falik missile is similar to the Iranian guided Khalij Fars missile and provides a range of 200 kilometers with an electro-optical seeker. These electro-optical seekers typically have a narrower field of view than a radar seeker. This means they require more accurate targeting, but at the same time, they are harder to decoy or jam than a radar seeker. Some experts believe that the Falik missile was derived from the Iranian Fajr 4 guided artillery rocket. However, Yemen declared that this missile was a product of its own development. One of Yemen's important missile achievements in the maritime and anti-surface field is the Zulfikar missile, which has been developed and supplied by Iran to deal with enemy ships at long distances. This missile, with an optical detector, a range of 700 kilometers, and equipped with a 579-kilogram warhead, can carry out both anti-ship and anti-surface attack operations. On 18 January 2025, the Yemeni army carried out a special military operation against the Ministry of War of Israel using the Zulfikar ballistic missile, and the missile accurately hit its target. Yemen has domestically produced a series of solid propellant-guided artillery rockets called Zelzal. The Zelzal II is a 610mm truck-launched rocket that has a payload of 600 kilograms and a range of about 200 kilometers, while the Zelzal III has an improved range of 250 kilometers. The use of this high-explosive missile has been considered to attack wide targets such as airport runways. One of the latest homegrown missiles developed indigenously by the Yemeni defense industry is the Aqil missile, a long-range surface-surface, liquid-fueled ballistic missile that can hit targets with high precision. The Tufan missile is another strategic surface-surface, long-range ballistic missile, which runs on liquid fuel and has high precision and devastating impact on the target. The earliest anti-ship cruise missiles the Yemeni forces have acquired are stocks of Soviet-made P-22 and C-801 naval missiles from China. The P-22s are part of a larger shore-based coastal defense missile system called Rubej. The P-22 and C-801S are advanced anti-ship cruise missiles with ranges of up to 80 and 40 kilometers, respectively. They both use active radar seekers to find their targets. The P-22s also have an infrared homing capability, which provides a valuable additional guidance option, especially in situations where there is heavy electronic warfare jamming. The more capable anti-ship cruise missiles that the Yemeni defense forces have since acquired include the Mandeb-2, land-to-sea ballistic missile, which is the first Yemeni missile with both optical and thermal targeting capability. It has a 400-kilometer range, and its warhead weighs 500 kilograms. This solid-fuel missile is a modified version of the Iranian Ghadir ballistic missile, which is widely used in coastal launchers and naval combat vessels. It employs an inertial guidance system for its initial phase and active radar guidance for its final phase. Ghadir missile weighs 700 kilograms and is comprised of a 165-kilogram warhead. The missile receives the position of sea targets from radars and moves toward them using an internal guidance system. After reaching the target, the missile locks onto it while guided in the form of an active radar.